This is ABC.
I'm Captain O.G. Reborn. My motto's tried and true. Read a book today, I bet you'll say O.G. I'll read more too.
Mad balls, gross for one, gross for all. We play with a mad ball, they're gross, funny, yucky, shit, there's eight holders. For eight more mad balls, snake bait, freaky fullback, splitting headache, lock lips, swine sucker, bruise brother, woof breath, fix face. We play with a mad ball. We play with a mad ball. Now eight great mad balls are joined by eight great more, sold separately from Aptoys.
Mad ball.
Chocolates, scrunchies, crunches. That's why I love Nestle Crunch. That's why I love Nestle Crunch.
Ice cream is crunches.
Ice cream?
Oh, and it crunches.
Ice cream.
That's why I love Nestle Crunch.
Nestle Crunch ice cream bars are scrunchies.
That's why we love Nestle Crunch.
They got their own thing to say, and together with their friends, ooh, the Rainbow Panthers, they'll say it better every day. It's the Sons of the Panther, Sons of the Panther, all right. Whoa. It's the Sons of the Panther, the Pink Pink Panther, all right.
We will return after these messages.
Nothing like rooting for our favorite team and eating Bonkers chewy candy. Now I'm trying a brand new flavor, chewy chocolate Bonkers. Rich chocolate outside, dark fudge inside. But it's still Bonkers, so I'm ready. Ha!
New chewy chocolate Bonkers. Bonks you up.
So candy!
Ooh-ah-ooh-ah-doo-doo-ah-ooh-ah, Starburst. Ooh-ah-ooh-ah-doo-doo-ah-ooh-ah, Starburst.
Fruit juice. Bite into a Starburst and hold on to your taste buds. Starburst! It's the wildest orange.
Orange!
Strawberry!
Strawberry!
Lemon! And wildest cherry taste! Starburst! It's a burst of refreshing fruit flavor! Naturally and artificially flavored.
Wild!
We now return to the Pink Panther and Sons.
Goodbye and good riddance.
Dad told me about this fishing spot, Panky. In fact, he was lucky to get away. Oh boy, I got a strike! Yow!
It's a hemp!
It's just an old piece of worthless junk. Chuck it! Sorry, guys. Good thing you're so hard-headed.
Here! You can have your old piece of junk back!
Hey! There's some writing on this thing. Contents, one genie, no preservatives added. Rub well for best results.
Hey, guys! What's happening? Hey, take it easy. This lamp isn't tattered inside, you know. Hey! How did you see that?
See what?
Some guy with a towel on his head just popped out of that old piece of junk. Let's find out what's going on, shall we?
Where'd you come from, sir?
Genie's my name. Granting wishes is my game.
A wish? You mean You'll grant any wish we want?
You got it, kid. So what's your wish?
Gee, I don't know. Can I think about it a minute?
Oh, sure. But I'm a busy man. Lots of places to go, people to meet, you know. Ooh, that's my phone. Look, think about it, guys, and I'll catch you later.
This is fantastic, Pinky. Let's get back to the clubhouse. Oh, boy. Wait till the gang sees this.
Ugh, disgusting.
But did you see that, Finko? We had that lamp, but we threw it back.
Don't worry about it, Howl. They may have the lamp now, but they won't have it for long.
I've never heard of weenies, or beanies, or genies.
Me neither. There's no such thing as magic lamps, right, Chadda?
Let us refer to the ultimate empirical authoritative reference source, the Encyclopedia.
Ah, here is our Mr. Ingenious Genie.
You're right, Chadda. That's the same genie that's in the lamp. Okay. Now for a personal demonstration. We just rubbed the lamp and... Hey, where's the lamp? I think we all know who's got the lamp. It starts with Fink and ends with O.
Finko!
Who else?
I know that genie guy came out of this lamp somehow.
I can't see a thing, Finko.
Here's how to get him. Rub well for best results. Yeah! All right, climb up while I...
Ooh, this place is so dirty, a dog could bury a bone in the rug. So what's it gonna be, kid? What's your wish? Come on, I'm in a hurry.
Come on, Fink, hurry up!
Hey, back off! I wish you guys would get lost. Yeah, that's better.
No, that's your wish.
Hey, where'd everybody go? Huh? Where are you guys? Hey, look what you made me do! Now I've got to get the genie to bring those clowns back! Hey! Where's the lamp? I should have known. That Finky Pinky stole it back! Now I've got to find Howl and his lost losers personally.
I don't know how we got here, but we're definitely lost.
Okay, Pinky, nobody's around, so now's a good time to have a little quiet confab with the genie.
Okay, guys, made up your mind yet? Give me your fondest wish.
Boy, I wish all the other kids could see this. Gee, you really gotta be mighty careful what you say around these genies.
Which way, Howl?
Yeah, now what?
Right, left, up, or down?
Cool it, guys. I'm concentrating. We go that way. We're still lost. We ain't ever gonna get back home. Finko, thanks for finding us. What was that for?
That's for making me lose the lamp.
We will return after these messages.
We're rocking in the good times just begun. And M&M's chocolate candy's a part of the fun. When you're strutting your stuff, anytime, anywhere. It's just when the place feels kinda right, out come your friends to light up the night. All the world loves M&M, cause the milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand. M&M.
I'm moving my feet. So neat, a new Kellogg's Pop-Tart taste.
Pop-pop-pop, my baby can't stop.
Cause peanut butter and jelly hits the spot. You know it tastes so good.
Yeah, I'm moving my feet to the Pop-Tart's beat. I'm moving real fast, cause they sure won't last.
Peanut butter, jelly inside, pastry on the outside.
Pop-pop-pop-tart.
Yeah, I'm moving my feet to a peanut butter jelly beat.
Cause it tastes so neat.
Crunchy on the waist, oh yeah!
part of this nutritious breakfast.
Now you can get a Swiss Miss sugar-free chocolate milk maker sample free in specially marked boxes.
Oh yeah, it's gonna be a golden Graham day.
I never thought I'd be so glad to see this dump again.
You can rest after we get that magic lamp back from those panthers.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, nice pad, Sonny. Now, what's your wish?
Why don't we wish for a new punching bag that doesn't punch back?
No, Rocco. What we really need is a new disk drive for the computer.
No, Annie. A new haddock. A hammock, maybe.
What's going on here? The nerve of that guy. Well, we'd better make up our minds about this wish. What's it gonna be?
Hold it!
We're getting nowhere fast. Hey, I read a story once where everything this king guy touched turned to gold. The golden touch. Why not wish for that? We can buy anything with gold.
Great idea! Let's wish for the golden touch.
Well, 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 here we are again. Once you make up your mind, you're just full of indecision. Now, do you have a wish or what?
Yes, sir, Mr. Genie. I wish I had the golden touch.
Oh, the golden touch, huh? Are you sure you want that?
Definitely.
Okay, you asked for it.
Well, might as well try it out.
Hey, we're rich!
We can get a new boathouse!
Okay, guys, this is it. 0 hour. We'll use our flying witch maneuver. Those panthers won't know what hit them. How exciting!
This lamp's too valuable to leave around here. I'm gonna bring it to Dad for safekeeping. Pinky! Pinky!
Gosh! Pinky touched you and he turned into gold!
Pinky? Pinky? Are you okay? We gotta get him back fast. I'll just get the genie to give us another wish. That'll get things back to normal. Don't worry, little fella. We'll get that lamp back, and you'll be as good as gold again. I mean, you won't be gold anymore.
Gotcha!
Taxi! Hey, taxi!
Wow, what a trip!
Hey, this golden touch is getting to be a real problem.
Here, Pinky, better you see.
Hey!
I finally made the golden glove!
They're getting away! Now we'll never get Panky back to normal!
Never say never. Look out, gang! The truck's losing its load!
I got it!
Come on, gang! We gotta get back to the clubhouse before a burglar steals Panky!
Hey, you kids are giving me some workout. What now?
We want to cancel that last wish. We don't want the golden touch.
Hey, I tried to warn you. Canceling a wish, that's quite irregular, you know. But maybe, on one condition.
Oh, you name it.
I need a vacation, so no rubbing the lamp for a while, okay? For at least 1,000 years or so, okay?
Okay!
Your wish for the golden touch is hereby canceled!
Hi, everybody!
Yay! Yay!
Well, Pinky, having a magic lamp sure isn't what it's cracked up to be. Well, Pinky, that's that.
Yeah, that's that.
Now we got that long walk home. I sure wish we had a ride. You know what, Panky? Maybe you don't really need a genie to make a wish come true.
We will return after these messages.
Captain O.G. Readmore here. Television's lots of fun, as everybody knows. You have your favorite characters, you have your favorite shows, but there are also other shows that aren't hard to find. Just read a book and turn on the TV in your mind. So many characters to meet. Oh, hello there. So many stories to be read. Oh, my. So read a book and take a look. Yes, sir. Excuse me. At the TV in your head.
Inside this soft furry ball is a neat new friend.
Party and Puffball Popple sold separately.
See? Pop goes the Popple.
Inside out, they twist and shout. The Popples love to party.
Girls!
You'll have a ton of fuzzy fun. Pop goes the Popple, Pop goes the Popple.
When you unpop a Popple, you let the fun out of the bag. 9 Popple characters, including Party and Puffball, come in different sizes and colors. Each Popple sold separately. From Mattel.
Wow! A new bunch from Kool-Aid that kids will really blow for! New Strawberry Falls Punch! A refreshing blend of strawberry and banana flavors! Everybody's falling for it! Even me! New Strawberry Falls Punch! Here's more Kool-Aid fun to fall for! Mighty GoBots and Lovable Pound Puppies Posables! You can get them free with proofs of purchase from Kool-Aid! Catch this Sunday's paper for details! Cause these great toys are gonna go fast!
We will return after these messages.
We now return to the Pink Panther and Son.
Relax, Rocco. You're only here for a checkup.
But I feel fine, Doc. I'm ready to go 15 rounds.
Well, your heart's certainly in fighting shape. Now we'll take a few x-rays, minus your boxing gloves.
Hang on, kiddo. We've got to get to the doctor's office pronto.
Right, Murphle. We will accompany Rocco to alleviate his apprehension at his clinical examination by a physician.
I'm glad that bout with the doc's over. Phew. And I did it without the other Panthers in my corner. Huh. They must be at the clubhouse.
There's Dr. Marcus Wealthy's office.
I'm glad to see him.
Yeah, I bet Rocco will be glad to see us.
Oh, here are Rocco's x-rays. Oh, and your mechanic is on line one.
Well, Fritz, how's my old sports car doing?
Oh, it's in bad shape there, Doctor. In fact, it's kaput.
That's a nasty sore throat, young man. Just have a seat and the doctor will see you.
We didn't come to see the doctor, ma'am. We're here to see our friend Rocco.
Oh, Mr. Rocco has already left. In fact, the doctor is examining his x-rays right now.
It confirms my worst fears. The body is completely worn out. Without a new pump, it won't last long.
I can't believe my ears. Rocco looks so healthy.
Oh, this is Sirian. Or Sirian. I'm serious.
Yeah, without an oil pump. 9. I will order a new one, mein Herr.
So we're looking at 2 days, a week at most.
Oh, no, Rocco isn't long for this world. The overall outlook for our fellow Panther is grim. Oh, Rocco.
Excuse me, but are you sure the doctor is looking at Rocco's x-rays?
See for yourself. I'm dead certain.
An unfortunately appropriate choice of words.
You said it, Murphle. We can't let Rocco know that we know he's a goner. These presents should cheer up, Rocco. These are for you, Rocco. I think you jumped the bell, gang. My birthday's not for 3 months.
Yeah, you won't be around.
We just want to show you how happy we are to have you for a friend.
We love you, Rocco.
Wow, new gloves. Thanks, Pinky. I'm floored. Try them on this new improved punching bag, Rocco. You're a real pal, Pinky. Go easy. You'll have plenty of time to break it in. I mean, enjoy yourself.
Look how brave Rocco is, acting as if nothing's wrong so he won't alarm us.
Take that. Gee, gang, this new bag is a knockout.
Rocco, are you okay?
Never felt better, kid.
Well, how about taking a rest, Rocco?
I'm getting terrible.
carried away by all this attention. Boy, this sure beats hitting the canvas, gang. There, all tucked in.
I inflate my flip adjustable pillow for your maximum comfort. Perhaps you'd like to elevate your extremities.
I think she means, do you want your feet popped? Or stopped? Propped up?
Thanks, Murple. I don't mind being KO'd by boxing magazines, especially when they feature my hero, Max Force. Max Force! I almost forgot! His championship boxing match is on TV in an hour!
Where do you think you're going?
I want to catch the Max Force bout on the tube, and there's no TV here!
Don't move! We'll be right back!
Boy, the guys are sure acting a little punchy today! Attaboy, Maxie! Give her a right! Give your mitts up! And a left! Fancy footwork. Exciting, huh, guys? That other guy's not gonna be around long. Yeah, and Maxie sure took care of his opponent.
Winner, Redskin World Champion, Max Force!
One of these days, I'm gonna meet him in person.
That doesn't give us much time.
Now these messages.
Ooh, you know what this is. Sure, it's a cool and creamy Eskimo Pie ice cream bar, covered with our own special rich dark chocolate. And you know what kids have been doing for over 65 years? Right, eating that great-tasting chocolate first. There's an Eskimo Pie size and shape to satisfy everyone. Old-fashioned Eskimo Pie on a stick and the original Eskimo Pie. Bet you have your own way to eat that great chocolate. Right, Laura?
We will return after these messages.
Kid, what's the difference between a mountain lion and me?
What, Sue?
2 inches. Run, kid.
Time for a powerful Cheerios breakfast. A balanced breakfast like this one.
We got go with Cheerios. Energy-os that help you grow. We got go, go, power with Power-os. Coming on strong with Cheerios. You're feeling your Cheerios.
A Cheerios breakfast.
Billy, there's a new drink mix.
Lion Pal!
Wow! Our drinks are scrumptious.
Delicious.
Yeah.
They're swell.
You'll love them, especially mine.
Let me taste. Great.
Who's there?
Bunny, Tweety.
Sure. What's up, Doc?
New Bugs Bunny and Pals drink mix.
With 100% NutraSweet and 100% vitamin C.
And Rocco just idolizes you, Mr. Force. Well, it would mean so much if you could pay him a visit before the final bell.
That's the saddest story I ever heard, kids. Your pal Rocco sounds like a real gem. I'd be proud to pay my respects.
We cannot express the overabundance of our appreciation at your acquiescence. What Jada means is thanks.
Max Force! I must be dreaming.
It's no dream, Rocco. He's real.
I'll get pictures for the Panther scrapbook.
Attaboy, Rocco. Lead with your left and keep your guard up.
Wow! Working out with a champ! I'm having the time of my life!
So long, Rocco.
All this excitement has induced feverish conditions that require a resumption of your supine position.
In other words, time to lie down, kiddo. We'll show the champ out.
Thanks, Mr. Force. Your visit sure meant a lot to poor Rocco.
Had such a mean left jab, too. I can hardly believe he's getting ready to leave the ring.
Gee, the champ's still here. Maybe I should get one more autograph.
We heard it straight from the doctor's mouth, champ. Rocco has only 2 days left to live.
2 days. Poor me.
Dr. Wealthy, are you here to give Rocco some treatments?
Treatments? I just came by to tell him about his tests. He's in perfect shape.
2 days to my final round. That's why my pals were being so nice.
Hey, you want to buy a lottery ticket? You might win $1 million.
Why bother? I won't be around to spend it. Gotta get all my allowance money out of the bank fast. Just time for a final fling. Yeah, think I'll give a big party for all my Panther pals. At least Rocco's gonna go out in style.
Yeah, the laugh's on us. Oh, no! Rocco's gone!
They've got to find him, then explain it's all a mistake.
Yeah, before he does something rash.
I'd like to KO my account here. You know, flatten it. Take out all my cash. The shopping cart bandit! That's me! Out of the way, kid! I'm taking all the cash! This is a stick-up! Now fill this cart up to the brim with lean green. I'm in a hurry.
Yeah, well, I'm in a bigger hurry. And I was here first, so scram.
Out of the way, punk!
You don't scare me, pal. I'm facing the final bell anyhow.
What's going on in the bank?
Shopping cart bandits robbing it.
Take that. I'm that.
That sounds like Rocco.
He's not so tough. Besides, I'm a goner anyway.
On the contrary, Rocco, we misconstrued the information concerning your premature mortality.
In other words, there's nothing wrong with you.
Nothing wrong with me?
There's soon gonna be. We'll see about that.
Ooh, there's a left jab, a right cross. What an uppercut. Couldn't have done better myself.
Boxer's foiled bank robbery. Here's another for your collection, Rocco.
Aw, thanks, Pinky. You know, I think the clubhouse would make a swell Rocco museum. People could touch the gloves I used to club on the shopping cart bandit. I could sign autographs. Maybe write a book about how brave and tough I was to KO that crook.
Well, Max Force lent a hand a glove, too.
Yeah, he helped a little.
Perhaps Rocco is sick after all, with a bad case of swelled head-itis.
You're right, kiddo. Hey, Rocco, today's your dentist appointment.
The dentist? Oh, no. Please, guys, don't let me face him alone. Please, come with me, please.
Sure, Rocco. What are friends for?
Big, brave Rocco.
We will return after these messages.
Are you ready? Because once you bite into a Three Musketeers bar, there's no turning back. It's so light it lifts you to the limit in chocolate taste. With a center whipped like a chocolate cloud and coated in velvet smooth chocolate. Go on, lighten up with Three Musketeers and let your spirits soar.
There's a new cereal in the neighborhood with O's and ghosts.
Tastes real good.
Ghostbusters! Marshmallow ghosts. Fruit-flavored O's. Ghostbusters taste great with milk and juice and toast. A nutritious breakfast with the ghost.
Ghostbusters!
Fruit-flavored O's.
Ghostbusters!
Marshmallow ghosts.
Ghostbusters!
What are you gonna crunch?
these messages.
Look, Toucan, my bird bot thinks they've got fruit flavors just like you.
Oh, almost. Fruit flavors, you ask? My nose was invented for the task.
How's it work?
Just follow my nose. It always knows. Kellogg's Fruit Loops cereal with natural fruit flavors. Orange, lemon, cherry, and lots of vitamin C. Part of this complete breakfast. Well?
I'd like to experiment further with Fruit Loops.
And you?
I compute. Need more fruit. Fruit.
Keebler presents the appealing taste of baked potato skins in a crispy, crunchy chip.
Potato skins got baked potato appeal, cause they're made with potatoes and skins that are real.
The Keebler elves make potato skins with real potatoes and real potato skins for a flavor with whole baked potato appeal.
Cheddar cheese and bacon, sour cream and chives, tasty baked potato, you won't believe your eyes. They're made with potatoes and skins that are real. Potato skins from Keebler, baked potato appeal.
ABC now continues with The Littles.
It's a good thing your shoes don't have shoelaces, or we'd never get to the conference on time. That must be Julia. Oh, I'm sorry I'm late. Come on in. My babysitter canceled on me.
Help!
Hey! Help! Help! Get me down!
I told you it wouldn't work, balloon brain!
Let me in!
I can't! My head's stuck in the valve!
We've got to get him down before something awful happens!
Help! 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 Help!
Ah! Careful, Lucy! Thanks. Look, Tom! A baby! Isn't he adorable?
You seen one? You seen them all?
We'll miss the opening speeches if we don't hurry.
You'd better go without me. The Archaeological Society isn't too keen on crying babies.
I sure would love to get a closer look at him.
Lucy, look out!
ABC now returns to The Littles.
Oh, no! They'll find Lucy for sure!
What was that?
Oh, Oscar just wants a little attention.
We've got to get Lucy before the bigs find her.
But how?
I don't know. Stinky! Why don't you watch where you're going, you... You genius, you!
Ha! I knew you'd realize how brilliant I am. Just what is it I did right?
You volunteered to take us down in that balloon gizmo of yours and rescue Lucy.
I did?
Open the vent, Tom. We're going down.
No, wait. This thing isn't safe for an inexperienced pilot. I can't see a thing, Grandpa Little.
That's probably why we're going in the right direction.
We're gonna be late if we don't get moving.
Oh, I'll stay here with Oscar until you two get back.
But, Julia, you've been waiting for 2 months to attend this conference.
Lucy, grab hold!
I can't reach!
Let out some more air, Dinky!
Tom, look out! Ow, that's the dog.
can I? Oh, no!
We're headed straight for the bigs!
Oh, where did that come from?
It's mine. I thought Oscar might like to play with it. Here you are, Oscar. That was very thoughtful of you, Henry.
We've got to get going.
Wait a minute, Julia. The conference isn't as important to me as it is to you. I'll babysit for Oscar.
Thanks, but I couldn't let you do that. I know. I'll babysit Oscar for you. Then you can all go.
But you've never babysat before, Henry.
No, but there's got to be a first time. Don't worry, I can do it.
You've got yourself a job, Henry. Try the bottle or the rattle if he starts to fuss.
Here's the number where we can be reached. We won't be long.
Sure thing, Mom.
Thanks for your help, Henry.
That was awful close, you guys.
It was nothing. I could have piloted us to safety blindfolded.
Is that a fact?
Isn't he just adorable, Grandpa?
Kind of reminds me of when you were a baby, Lucy. Why, you are no bigger than a pea.
I've got to get a closer look.
Lucy, be careful. He may be a baby, but compared to us, he is still a giant.
Hi, little Oscar. He's so soft.
Look out, Lucy. He's going to grab you. Kiss someone your own size, you little monster.
I think he likes you, Grandpa.
He'd like to rattle my brains out is what he'd like.
Someone's at the door. Hide. Hi, Terry. Hi, Chuck. What's happening?
Just a game of touch football in the dirt lot by old man Bridges' house, Henry. Want to play?
Yeah, I'd like to, but I've got to babysit.
Oh, tough break, Henry. It's the last game before school starts.
Oh, hey, hold it, you guys. I'll be right back. Tom, Lucy, I need a big favor.
Sure, Henry, what is it?
You think maybe you could babysit Oscar for an hour?
No way!
We'd love to!
Henry promised he'd babysit for Oscar, not us. It's his responsibility.
But Grandpa, he's just a baby.
He may look like a baby, but in reality, he's a 20-pound drooling disaster area.
Lucy's right, Grandpa Little. Oscar can't do anything. He can't even walk. Besides, he'll probably sleep till I get back.
Sounds awful dangerous to me.
You're not afraid, are you, Dinky?
Afraid? Me? But don't be silly. Babysitting is one of my specialties. Why, I've sat on more babies than you can shake a rattle at.
Then it's settled. I'll bring Oscar up to my room so you can be closer to home in case you need anything.
But...
it'll be fun, Grandpa. You'll see.
Remember, Lucy, if he starts crying, just give him some milk.
But how? The bottle's twice as big as me.
This isn't a good idea, Henry. Babies are a big responsibility.
Don't worry, Grandpa Little. If anything goes wrong, Dinky just has to fly his plane across the street and get me. Thanks again.
How do we make him stop? must be hungry. We've got to feed him.
Grab hold, Dinky. We'll give him his milk.
It's getting away, Grandpa Little.
Well, don't just stand there. Go get it.
Whoa, I can't stop it. Get this thing off of me! Hey, cut that out! You're scratching my head!
Now look what you've done, Dinky!
Me? That little guy nearly sucked my brains out! Oh no! He's getting out! I'm an expert in baby karate. Don't make me do anything I'll regret.
Dinky, watch out!
Help!
Oscar, don't touch that!
Oscar, no!
We will return after these messages.
Oh, what I wouldn't do to get Fruity Pebbles with grape flavor.
Say, aren't you?
Grape is what I like. Give me Fruity Pebbles and I'll let you ride my bike.
Here, you love these Fruity Pebbles with grape flavor.
Purple, purple. Grape, grape. Fruity Pebbles taste so great.
Morning.
Uh-oh. Time to pick up the beat.
Of Fruity or Cocoa Pebbles cereal. Part of this nutritious breakfast. Yabba dabba delicious.
ABC now continues with The Littles.
Follow me, Dinky. Help me push on Henry's hockey stick. Be quick and start pushing.
Hurry, Grandpa!
Ah!
Lucy, look! The wires on Henry's machine are smoking!
Oscar, no!
Oscar, don't touch it!
Stop! It'll burn you!
Stop?
Good boy, Oscar. Follow us.
Pinky, quick! We've got to stop that smoking!
How do we stop it?
Grab that sock! We've got to unplug it. Quick, Dickie, help me pull.
He's too strong.
Here, Oscar. Here, boy.
We've got to get Oscar out of here before the fire spreads!
But how? The door and window are closed!
I'll see if I can open the window to let out some of the smoke. Lucy, you warn your mom and dad. Tom, call the Littles Fire Department!
Right!
Will do, Grandpa!
Hey! What about me?
Just keep him away from the flames, Dickie, until we get things under control!
I'll keep him away from the flames, but who's gonna keep him away from me?
Mom, Dad, where are you?
Fire department, here it is!
Gone shopping, back in an hour. Mom and Dad!
Fire department!
We'll be right over, Tom.
It's no use. I can't open it any further, and Henry's too far away to see us. I told you it was a mistake, Henry Big.
The fire department is here.
Fish.
swimming and send down those fish.
Okay.
Lucy and Oscar are trapped by the flames.
There's only one thing we can do. Where is that wet head when I need it?
Give me my goggles, you scaly thief, you!
Dinky! Gas up your plane! We've got to get Henry!
Aye, aye, Grandpa Little. I'll be right down.
There he is, Dinky. Buzz overhead and we'll get his attention.
Roger.
He didn't see us.
We've got to get closer.
Hey, Chuck,
here comes the bomb.
Dinky, look out.
Oh, no.
Hey, what did I hit?
Grandpa Little, Dinky, are you all right?
We're okay, but your bedroom's on fire.
Oscar! I've got to get home and put it out!
You'll do no such thing, Henry. You're going to call the big fire department.
Don't cry, Oscar.
Lucy, Lucy! Are you okay?
I figured he'd be okay.
Sorry isn't enough, Henry. You're just lucky you saw the smoke when you did, or things could have been a lot worse.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Clifford. I realized how lucky I was that nobody got hurt. From now on, I'll take my responsibilities more seriously, and I won't take a job unless I'm willing to see it through.
Well, I guess if Oscar can forgive you, so can I.
You're grounded, and you'll have to pay for the damages out of your allowance.
I hope you've learned a lesson too, Lucy Little.
I sure have, Grandpa. I know now that I shouldn't try to do something I can't handle.
And neither should I.
We've all learned a big lesson, and from now on, we'll only babysit Littles.
Hey, Henry, you want to help us show all our big friends how to make a Littles elevator?
Sure, what do I do?
We'll tell you in a minute. Okay, Dinky, you cut out a doorway in this empty milk cart.
Okay, Tom, pass the string to me.
What do I do?
We'll tell you in a minute.
What we did was put a loop of string through the top of the milk carton so that the carton is attached to the ball of string.
But what do I do?
Henry, your job is to unroll the string so it loops around the doorknob.
That's all I do?
Nope. Now you pull.
Oh, I knew there was a catch to this.
Going up.
Thanks, Henry. Whee!
Hey, guys, what's in all the buckets?
Coco.
All right. Did you save me any?
Sure. A whole box full.
Snap, crackle, pop, Cocoa Krispies.
Kellogg's Cocoa Krispies, a chocolatey part of this complete breakfast.
And this really is chocolatey.
With all those buckets, you can't miss.
You can rev up for action because Hot Wheels are here. They're fast-moving, high-performance speed machines. And one's free with one purchase of Cocoa Krispies.
Cinnamon,
toast crunch.
Cinnamon and sugar, we're baking up a bunch. We bake homemade paste in the cinnamon.
Toast crunch.
We're cinnamon and sugar shakers.
Wow.
We're cinnamon toast crunch bakers.
Cinnamon Toast Crunch cereal tastes like homemade cinnamon toast.
A toasty part of this nutritious breakfast.
Baking homemade taste.
It's like homemade.
In the cinnamon toast crunch.
ABC now continues with The Littles. It's the Bugs Bunny and Tweety Show, together with some of their very closest friends.
This promises to be fun.
If you laugh.
Oh, this is my very favorite show.
Get in on the fun with the Bugs Bunny and Tweety Show.
Tomorrow, two brand new stories in a special double feature, Case Busters and My Town, on the Disney Sunday Movie. Wednesday, it's a bittersweet reunion for MacGyver and his grandfather when both become targets of assassins on MacGyver. And now stay tuned for Laugh Olympics next. This is ABC.
Heavens to hilarity! This is it, sports fans! Participants, even! Television's greatest array of stars! Laugh Olympics presents the round-the-world triple-team competition between the Yogi Yahooies, the Scooby-Doobies, and the really Raccoons! The players are on the field, in the stadium even, so let's get on with it! Laugh Olympics!
Return after these messages.
When you get up to get a drink, you really ought to stop and think about the ways to quench your heavy thirst. The refrigerator is loaded, but before you grab a soda, why not try a big wet glass of water first? Oh, water is a drink that you can trust. No one's ever lost a tooth from us. So drive, drink six glasses, use the Fountain Beach. real classy when you're thirsty. Reach for water. You know you really ought to. It's the best no-calorie drink in all the world.
And hidden inside the mask slingshot, there's a mini jet, a control.
Tracker here. A simple mask. Security break. Let's roll, team.
Jump like spine, boy.
Invert vampire.
Giant fly.
Not so fast, good. Slingshot engaged.
Mask vehicles and Boulder Hill, each sold separately with a figure. Mask, where illusion is the ultimate weapon. Mask, slingshot, and vampire, each sold separately. New from Kenner.
And now these messages.
Done at last.
Cool, geez. How about some M&M's?
Hi, dibs.
Candies. The milk chocolate melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
See you later.
Those lonely pound puppies really need to be rescued.
Pound puppy, I'm so glad to find you. Put that lonely puppy pound behind you.
You need a name. I'll call you Freckle.
Lots of pound puppies need your love.
Ask for me, Petey.
And when they're this lonely and this lovable, one more is always welcome.
Come share in all our cuddling care and puppy love.
Pound puppies. Each sold separately. From Tonka.
Funny Drunk, you'll do anything to get the real cookie taste of Cookie Crisp cereal.
I know. It even looks like a little chocolate chip cookie.
But it stays crispy and milk, and it's part of this complete breakfast.
If you like cookies, you'll love Cookie Crisp.
And if you like bubble gum, you'll love Bubblicious. Free and Cookie Crisp. It's the ultimate bubble. In strawberry, raspberry, and new chocolate mint. You can try all three flavors. There's one pack free in Cookie Crisp cereal.
We'll return after these messages.
It's exciting. It's the Post Cereal's Great Toy Giveaway. Millions will enter. 100 kids win a $1,000 all-you-can-haul shopping spree at Toys R Us. To enter, look inside specially marked boxes of Post Alphabets, Honeycomb, Super Golden Crisp, Cocoa and Fruity Pebbles cereal for instant winner game cards.
I won.
Or for free entry, write Box 4071, Blair, Nebraska, 68009. It's all you can haul.
We will return after these messages.
Kid, what's the difference between a mountain lion and me?
What, Sue?
2 inches. Front, kid.
Time for a powerful Cheerios breakfast. A balanced breakfast like this one.
You got to go with Cheerios. Energy-os that help you grow. You got to go power with Power-os. Coming on strong with Cheerios. You'll feel it, your Cheerios.
fun right in your bowl, and you're gonna wanna come flying. For horses and hoops, balls and bears, elephants and lions.
Huh?
Horses, hoops, balls, bears, elephants and lions. New Circus Fun cereal. Crunchy red hoops, speckled balls, and many marshmallow animals. Circus Fun, a spectacular part of this complete breakfast. New Circus Fun cereal.
He must not escape us. Search everywhere.
If you don't mind my saying so, Master Mungo, I don't think this is a safe place for man or droid. That fellow over there, for instance. He looks like the sort who would just as soon carbon freeze you as look at you. Oh my, he's coming over here.
Relax, 3PO. That's Croc. He's the one we're here to see. Good to see you again, Crocs. I take it you have what I want.
What you and everyone else wants, Mungo. I've been one step ahead of Imperial Stormtroopers all day. Let's finish the deal so I can blow this planet.
At last, the map to the rune system.
Really, Artu, this is no time to dance.
Uh-oh. Trouble. Nice doing business with you. See you around.
Oh dear. Now what do we do, Master Mungo?
Keep calm. Maybe they're not looking for us.
You're under arrest in the name of the Emperor.
Then again, I could be wrong.
Come with us.
R2's jamming their audio amplifiers. Let's go!
After them! The Emperor wants that map!
3PO, R2, follow me!
Halt!
Hang on! Oh dear! We lost them! Next up, the Baobab Archives. Now, let's see what we've got. What's it say, 3PO?
These are coordinates for the rune system, sir. According to this hologram, it is hidden in a dust cloud called the Cloak of Sith.
Great. The rainbow comets pass by Manda once every season on their way to the rune system. If we can find information on their course, we can use it to lead us there.
If I may suggest, sir, it might be easier to find the information by talking to the archivist droid. I'm sure he's around. Ah, there he is. Excuse me, my master is looking for information on the rune comet. Do you think...
That's it, R2. The astrogation coordinates for the rainbow comets. Record them.
You, I take it, are the archivist? Well, I must tell you that I find your catalog system less than satisfactory. Excuse me. Good news, Master. I've found the archivist. I'm sure he can direct us to the information. What do you mean you've already found it?
Let's go, 3PO.
But, sir, don't you think we should ask the archivist just to make sure? Not that I don't have complete faith in R2's data retrieval circuits, if I'm not being too inquisitive, sir. Just why is this rune system so important?
Runestone, 3PO. And we're going to be the first to open a trade route to it.
Oh, no. Not another space voyage. Excuse me, I just remembered I have a previous engagement. Well, I suppose it can wait until we get back.
Admiral Screed. This probe droid has just returned from the Cloak of Sith.
Excellent. Now we will learn if there are any systems worth conquering in that cloud of cosmic dust. Activate it.
Greetings to the Emperor from Governor Coombe of Town Tomb Province, Planet Ruin. I wish to extend to you the warmest welcome. There are many reasons why Ruin would make a valuable ally to the Empire. I make you a gift of one of them.
A rune stone.
The most valuable gem in the galaxy. I look forward to dealing with the Empire.
We shall deal with you, Kung, however we see fit.
I have programmed directions into this probe droid.
Deprogram it. Set course for the Cloak of the Sith immediately. Runestone.
Oh, how I hate space travel. But perhaps it will be an uneventful voyage. This rune system may be a very peaceful place. Well, if you don't agree, I don't want to hear it.
Maybe by opening up a new trade route, we can save my father's merchant fleet from financial ruin.
All the same, sir, I have a bad feeling about this.
You have a bad feeling about everything, 3PO.
Look, the Rainbow Comets. We've timed their orbits perfectly. They'll take us right to the rune system.
Just as I thought. The comet's light will lead us safely through the asteroid field.
But only if one of those asteroids doesn't hit us.
3PO, you worry too much. R2's perfectly capable of dodging those asteroids, right, R2? Hey! Nothing's working. That jolt must have paralyzed our stabilizers.
Now that is what comes from overconfidence, R2. Oh, no! We're heading right for that radioactive cloud. We're doomed. Artu, do something quick! The radiation in that ion cloud will be deadly for Master Mungo. Not to mention what it will do to our circuits. There must be something in this databank that can help us.
There's only one chance. If I can just get the aft thrusters aimed at the cloud, we might be able to blast our way through.
It worked!
I can't find anything in these databanks to help. We're doomed.
We're safe, 3PO.
We are. We're safe. Hooray!
R2, readjust those stabilizers. We've got to get back in the comet's tail.
Master Mungo, surely you don't mean to continue with this, I must say, reckless plan?
Of course.
I should have guessed.
I think we've found something. The sensors show a planetary system within that dust cloud. 3PO, this may be what we've been looking for. New worlds open before us. What wonders will we see?
I think we're about to find out. Huh? My sentiments exactly. Sir, what is it?
Whatever it is, it's got us in a tractor beam. It's gigantic. We're being pulled into its mouth.
Oh, my!
Remember, just keep calm and let me do the talking.
Greetings.
Quiet, Artu.
Welcome to the new Umbo Light Station. Sorry about the tractor beam. We just wanted to make sure you docked without trouble. We are honored to play host to emissaries from the Empire.
Master Mungo, they seem to think that we are
I know. Thank you, but I'm afraid we're not emissaries. That is, not exactly. We're here more as, observers. Quit slouching, droid.
Governor, they are not quite what I expected Imperial emissaries to be.
Quiet, Geth. You'll offend them. Allow me to show you around. As you'll see, I have much here that will interest the Empire.
Whoa!
Oh.
They're mine.
That's better.
Oh. Ah. Oh, no.
Welcome to the heart of my operation. Behold the treasures of the Empire system. All mine. This is where I store crates of Nergon 14. There are many interested parties who'd pay an Imperial ransom for that rare explosive. And they do. I assure you, our business here is quite profitable. These are mupples, a prized delicacy, very valuable. And soon, even greater treasures of cargo will be mine, riches beyond compare, free of charge.
Sir, I believe these ruffians are nothing more than pirates. We should take our leave immediately.
Watch it, you little rust bucket.
As I was saying, sir.
If we try to leave now, we may give ourselves away.
Look.
Huh?
Let go of me, you space pirates. You think you're hot stuff, huh? Well, the Empire doesn't rule the Cloak of Sith yet.
I apologize for that prisoner's bad behavior. Would you like to have him mind-flogged?
No. Thanks. Who is he?
Just an old man who used to be in charge of the old Umbo Light Station. Before I closed it down, this is the new Umbo Light Station, and its duty is to make me rich.
Governor Kuhn, look!
An Imperial shuttle.
Greetings from the Emperor. I am Admiral Screed.
But if you are the Emperor's representative, then who are the imposters? Stop them!
Shall we leave now, sir?
Take them.
Quick!
Hey! The what? Now stay there. Wait for me!
We've lost them.
So we meet again, Baobab.
Not for long.
Don't waste your energy.
In here! Good work, R2.
Now what, sir? Over there!
And there! Get down!
Which way?
Uh-oh.
There they are!
Split up! Trapped! At least the stormtroopers don't know where I am.
They don't, but I do!
No, this way, R2. Don't be foolish, R2. That way will lead us right back to them. We want to go this way. Of course, I could be wrong.
Demobilize them!
Oh, no! We're being... apart! Shutting down!
Admiral Screed has plans for them!
We will return after these messages.
Almost 12.
Brian, would you care to share with the rest of the class?
Choppery Cocoa Pebbles.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Rook.
Rook who?
Rook Bug. To clean up your act.
Clean up my act? Can you clean up this place?
Stand back!
Oh, no, not my Cocoa Pebbles!
Cocolicious!
Barney, you tricked me out of my pebbles!
Time for a clean getaway.
Post Cocoa or Fruity Pebbles cereal, part of this nutritious breakfast. Yabba dabba delicious!
Oh, 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 my best friend and an Oreo cookie. She loves the crunchy chocolate, I like the creamy middle. Been eating them this way since we were very little. We'll always be friends with O-R-E-O. Friends are better when you pair them. Oreos are better when you share them.
Oreo cookies, share them.
Nabisco.
The droids are shut down, Admiral Screed.
And so is this one. He'll be out for several hours.
Good work, Gaff. Let's find out who he is.
No need to search him. He's Mungo Baobab of the Baobab Merchant Company. The Emperor has been looking for him for some time.
Just a case of mistaken identity, Admiral. Please accept this Babble-Bob fellow as a, shall we say, servant of the Empire.
Throw him in that cage.
And as for you...
R2, look out! Those stormtroopers are going to fire! Oh, dear! I... Surrender.
You can keep the R2 unit, Kung, but I can use this protocol droid. Prepare him for reprogramming.
Yes, sir.
Reprogramming? Oh, no, thank you. I'm quite happy with the way I am now.
Come on, rust bucket.
That's nice. What? Yeah. What's going on here? Get away from me. Get away. Go on. Beat it.
That's not the way to handle Muppets.
And just how do you handle them?
Like this.
Phew, thanks.
Noop's the name. Noop Yeldarb. I guess I had you figured wrong. Thought you was part of Kung's rotten plan.
Stop! Master, help! They're going to reprogram me! You can't do this.
Oh, yes, we can. Any preferences as to a new name? You'll need one to go with your new behavioral circuitry matrix.
Well, I've always been partial to Ant. Oh dear, what am I saying? R2, Master Mungo, help!
R2, 3PO! It's all my fault. If I hadn't been so headstrong, we wouldn't be in this mess.
You may attempt to convince me that your petty pirating operation is worth something to the Empire.
You wound me, Admiral. Our plan has worked perfectly and will continue to work. By the way, we prefer salvaging to pirating. Ever since Gaff closed down the old Umbu Light Station on my orders, we've been luring trade ships to destruction with our false beacons. Soon all the wealth of the rune system will be mine.
You mean ours, Governor Kung.
Master Mungo, help! R2!
We've got to do something. Can't you think of a way to help 3PO?
Sure. Lots of them. Unfortunately, they all hinge on us not being in here. Move it, droid. Hey! I think he blew a circuit.
What's going on here?
R2, am I glad to see you?
Count.
We're free! Good work, R2. Let's move.
Don't let them get away. Down, Bob.
Nice hat, 3PO.
Look out!
Stop them!
Here we go again!
Hey!
Up, look out!
Those boxes are full of Nergon 40!
Oh!
My... explode!
The Nergon 14! Don't let those boxes fall on the engines!
That'll slow them down!
Everybody in?
Fools! We're getting away!
Explosions? The engines are breaking down. We're moving into the asteroid belt. We'll crash.
That way! We're not out of this yet. Hey, fella! Cat!
My men will have everything under control.
Abandon ship!
Is this how you run a salvaging operation?
A minor setback, Admiral. Let's get out of here.
Take Baobab ship. I know it's fast.
All personnel have abandoned ship, Governor Cole. Except for Baobab and his friends.
Come on, we'll have to take Kung's ship. The pirates may have escaped, but at least their operation is over.
Why do these alien life forms find me so irresistible?
Now, Admiral, don't do anything you might regret.
I won't regret it, Kung, but you will. Throw them in the brig.
But without me, you won't find the source of the rune stones.
Thanks for all your help, Mungo. If there's anything I can do...
There is. You can tell us where the rune system is.
Master Mungo, you still mean to continue searching for rune stones?
We have no choice, 3PO. This cloud craft won't make it back, Demanda. If the rune system isn't close by, we're stuck here.
Oh, it's close by, all right. Just look. Welcome to the ruin system.
I've found it. I'll establish a trade route for the Baobab merchant fleet yet.
I'm afraid I still have a bad feeling about it, sir, but maybe all the surprises are over now.
Maybe they are. 3PO, get the astrogation charts.
Certainly, sir. They should be in this compartment.
Then again, maybe not.
R2-D2, do something!
Oh no, what next?
We'll return after these messages.
Peanutty cream comes together with a crunchy candy shell. What you got is Reese's Pieces, one great tasting candy. In a crazy world where things don't always fit, it's great to know there are some that do. Reese's Pieces, the winning combination.
Child dolls, each sold separately. There's one meant just for you.
You were meant for me. Hair that's soft and silky too. Eyes so big and blue. Sits while mommy ties your shoe. Can you stand up too? Big girl, standing by yourself.
You are the one for me. You're my child.
Mattel Pampers diaper. New from Mattel.
Smurf will return after these messages.
The night Birdie the early bird came to McDonaldland.
Marlo, open that box, please, please, I beg.
Why, inside's a wonderful egg.
So they made it a nest, kept it warm through the night.
That egg cracked a smile.
What a beautiful sight.
Now, Ronald knew if he brought on the day, that early bird would come out.
Tell McDonaldland's where I'll stay.
It's a good time for the great taste.
You betcha!
Of McDonald's.
I know why I love mine. I feel like I do. I see it's got a real fruit taste. Vitamin C too.
Wally.
There's a bear called Wally who'll try anything to get...
Ooh, that honey sweet taste.
Your Kellogg's Honey Smacks.
I'll give you $100,000 for the next spoonful.
Get lost, Wally.
I'm a bear. If I don't get my honey sweet taste, my food will fall right out.
Goodbye, Wally.
Honey Smacks is part of a good-for-you breakfast. Puffs of wheat smacked honey sweet.
I can get some movies. I know people. And commercials.
Honey Smacks taste sweet as honey.
Billy, there's a new drink mix.
Our drinks are scrumptious.
Delicious. Yeah.
They're well.
You'll love them, especially mine.
Let me taste. Great.
Who's there?
Bunny, Tweety.
Sure. What's up, Doc?
New Bugs Bunny and Pals Drink Mix.
With 100% NutraSweet and 100% vitamin C.
McCloud and Doc Terror each sold separately.
Trouble in forever, Jake! Intercession assault mode!
Let's do it!
My name is Doc Terror Dam!
Centurion!
Take this!
Energize the power mode!
Bullets away!
Fire!
Now stuff your balls! Right, Jake?
Right, Ace!
New Centurions! Jake Rockwell, Ace McCloud, and Doc Terror come as shown, each sold separately.
Ah, cousin!
We're not cousins, Wally.
There's a bear called Wally who'll try anything to get...
Ooh, that honey sweet taste.
Your Kellogg's Honey Smacks.
I'll give you $100,000 for the next spoonful.
Get lost, Wally.
I'm a bear. If I don't get my honey sweet taste, my food will fall right out.
Goodbye, Wally.
Honey Smacks is part of a good-for-you breakfast. Puffs of wheat smacked honey sweet.
I can get some movies. I know people. And commercials.
Honey Smacks taste sweet as honey.
you're going to hear is a very scary story. I don't expect you to believe it. I wouldn't have. It happened in this house, which is where I live, with a family called the Monroes. It's kind of a nice place to live, and, well, oh, I guess I ought to introduce myself. The name's Harold. That's me there, trying to catch some sleep. And that's Chester, doing what Chester's usually doing, reading a book. Mr. Monroe, that's him on the left, is a scientist. Mrs. Monroe takes care of Toby, Pete, and Chester and me. But on the day all this started, she was more worried about her husband.
It's all those accidents they've been having at the plant. So many mysterious things have been happening there. A lot of folks around here even think the plant is haunted.
Haunted? Well, now, I never believed in ghosts myself. Still, here at the Worldco food processing plant, something was very wrong.
We're going to have to work on that freeze-dried vegetable program. Monroe, check with research about the latest developments they have. Look out! This accident was too close, Monroe.
The boss was determined that this, the ninth accident, would be the last. He decided to close the plant.
But you can't, Mr. Newton. Everyone in this town depends on this plant for their income. Without jobs, they'll just...
That support rope was chewed through, Monroe. Now, I don't know if it's ghosts or what's causing these accidents. But as of now, the Worldco food processing plant is closed.
When we got there to drive Mr. Monroe home, all the plant workers were going home for keeps.
Without that plant functioning, it's the end of this town.
Hey, Mom, Pop, look what we found.
Toby and Pete had found a shoebox in some tall weeds. And in it was a rabbit. Just a cute, fuzzy little bunny rabbit. Fast asleep.
Oh, isn't he cute? Kitsy, kitsy, come, little bunny.
Hey, there's a note in here. It's written in some sort of foreign language.
Look, I'll bet you that's the bunny's name. Funicula. You know, like Dracula.
I want to suck your blood.
Well, maybe they couldn't read the note, but I could. There's a lot of Russian wolfhound in my veins. It said, take good care of my baby.
Can we take him home and feed him, Dad?
I don't know if we'll even be able to feed ourselves with the plant closing, but I suppose so.
There was a full moon that night. The little rabbit slept all the way to the store where Mrs. Monroe selected some vegetables for it.
Is the rabbit still asleep? He's not asleep. He's gone. Hey, Mom, the rabbit got away.
A rabbit? Loose in my store? Hurry, catch him.
Don't worry. Harold will catch him. Come on, we'll look up this aisle.
We looked all over for that little rabbit until I found him atop a bin of tomatoes. At least I thought I did. How he got over there, I'll never know. But good tracker that I am, I went after him.
Hey, dog, get off those pumpkins. They're not safe.
That's the trouble with humans. They always tell you things too late.
Harold! They're coming this way. Don't announce it. Run!
Look what you kids have done. That dog of yours, I'll... I really needed this tonight, too.
Look, Harold found Funicula. Good boy. Are you okay, little bunny? Let's get him home. He looks scared.
I just hope the man isn't too angry about what we did to his store.
Mr. Monroe had to pay for 51 pumpkins, which didn't please him a whole lot.
I'm so glad to see customers leave in my whole life.
Sir, I just came across some of these in the bins. I never saw a white tomato before.
Neither have I. It's like all the juice was just drained out of it. I wonder what could have caused this.
We didn't know about the tomatoes then. When we got home, there were more important matters to discuss.
I'm keeping the bunny in my room. I found Benicula. He sleeps in my room. You can keep smelly old Harold in your room.
At least I don't wear the same socks for 3 days in a row.
We'll keep the rabbit in here. That way neither of you will have it in your room. We'll leave Benicula on this table.
Benicula? It sounds like Dracula. Tell me again about the note. Tell me again.
We found it with the rabbit. It was in Romanian, and it said...
Romanian? Romania is where Transylvania is, and Transylvania's where Dracula is from. It's all in this book I read.
Oh, come on, Chester. He couldn't have anything to do with Dracula. Besides, Dracula was a vampire.
Uh-huh. There is dirt in the bottom of that box, and I read that vampires always line their coffins with dirt from their home country. I read books. I know. I know.
Let's go to sleep. Chester.
Coming, coming.
I slept soundly all night. Chester didn't. In fact, you've no idea what he tried to get me to believe the next morning.
I saw him, Harold. He rose out of the shoebox and snuck into the kitchen.
The rabbit snuck into the kitchen?
And I heard the refrigerator door open and close. I did.
You must have seen Mr. Monroe sneaking a midnight snack.
Not unless he wears bunny pajamas and gets very tiny at night.
Everybody, come in here. I found this in the refrigerator. It's a tomato. But it's all white. And there's no juice left in it.
No juice in it? Like someone went into the refrigerator last night and sucked it all out. Like a vampire.
There are no such things as vampires. Especially vampire rabbits.
Are you sure?
Gee, I hope so.
And now these messages.
Crystal Swift Wings, Starburst She-Ra, and Catradolf each sold separately.
Now, your beautiful wings and magic horn.
I want Crystal Swift Wings.
My dazzling Starburst cape will stop you.
Outshined again.
I think Catra has seen the light.
Starburst She-Ra and Crystal Swift Wings each sold separately. New from the Princess of Power collection, Catra also sold separately.
Kids, what's the difference between a mountain lion and me?
What, Sue?
2 inches.
Time for a powerful Cheerios breakfast. A balanced breakfast like this one.
You got go with Cheerios. Energy-os that help you grow. You got go, go, power with Power-os. Coming on strong with Cheerios. You're feeling your Cheerios.
A Cheerios breakfast.
Now, back to our story. In the days that followed, more and more white tomatoes turned up. And it wasn't just tomatoes either. There were white carrots and white lettuce and cucumbers too, all drained of every drop of juice. After a few days, they started turning up all over the block. Meanwhile, Chester got more and more suspicious.
Hold still, hold still! I know the book I want is up here. I examined one of the white tomatoes, and I found teeth marks on the skin. One large tooth, perhaps like a rabbit's buck teeth.
Your tail's in my nose.
Don't worry, Harold. I'm okay. And I found the book I wanted.
Thrilling.
Wait, Harold, wait. This book tells all about vampires.
I don't want to hear any more about vampires.
Everyone is upset about the plant closing. Some of them think it was haunted by some sort of demon.
Hey, Hank, down the street, claims he saw a wolf stalking through the plant.
Now they're upset about white tomatoes. Folks are talking about moving away, like this whole town is haunted.
Around 10 that evening, we all turned in, all except Chester, that is.
Night, Harold.
The rabbit sleeps all day.
So do you. So do I.
And he has long pointed teeth like a vampire has.
Well, so do you. And so do I.
But the note written in Romanian, the stalking at night to appease his thirst, the dirt in the shoebox, the stories of demons at the plant where he was found, that is a vampire rabbit.
Okay, I'll prove to you how silly that is. Tonight, we'll keep an eye on him. We'll stay awake in shifts and see if he leaves that box.
He's a vampire, like Dracula.
Welcome to my laboratory.
Blah, blah, blah. The vampire turns into a bat and stalks his prey. Then when he sights it, he attacks.
Meow.
I haven't got enough problems with the plant closing and all the weird vegetables. Now I got a crazy cat on my hands.
It was 2 hours past my bedtime. But there I was, standing guard on a sleeping rabbit.
Okay, your turn to sleep, my turn to watch.
What's that I smell? It smells like garlic.
It is garlic. It says in that book I read that garlic keeps vampires away.
You keep that stuff on, and you keep everyone away. Phew, wake me in 3 hours. While I was dozing, Chester got a bit too engrossed in his reading.
Harold, Harold, he's gone! Harold, wake up, he's gone! The bunny is gone right under our noses! Wake up, wake up! Must have gone out this way. We gotta pick up his trail.
I was so busy sniffing, I didn't notice a wire strung across the yard. Unfortunately, Chester found it, or rather, his tail did.
I told you, Alice. I told you those booby traps I set would catch the poacher in the garden.
And you'll wake up the whole neighborhood.
Now we'll find who's been turning our vegetables white.
Within minutes, practically the whole neighborhood was out there.
This tomato has turned white, and there are rabbit tracks around it.
The only rabbit in town is the one at the Monroes.
Yeah, Benicula. The one whose name sounds like Dracula.
Dracula? Dracula? Hey, it makes sense. Those tomatoes were drained of juice like Dracula drains a victim.
Hey, wait, listen. Dracula can turn himself into a bat, right? Maybe he can turn himself into any sort of rodent.
Everyone, everyone, remember that wolf I said I saw at the plant before they closed it? Well, Dracula can turn himself into a wolf, right?
That rabbit at the Monroes has something to do with this.
Well, what are we waiting for?
Let's get that vampire rabbit.
We'll make them have it over.
We will return after these messages.
It's breakfast, all right. I'll go
fuck it. Can nothing stop these doggies?
Ah! Crunch Power can. It locks delicious sweet taste in.
Yikes!
So it's tough to suck out.
You got the point.
Captain Crunch is a crunchy part of a balanced breakfast.
Phooey.
I got a free Nestle Crunch from Cap'n Crunch.
Now in specially marked boxes of Cap'n Crunch cereal, a coupon for one of five Nestle's candy bars.
All right.
Now from Cap'n Crunch.
The sun is getting hotter.
Oh, look, is that some water? What's this crazy Sigma jiggle? It's a squiggly water wiggle.
What you doing, you're a giggle.
Water wiggle.
crazy water wiggle. You can't tell what he'll do. You think you're chasing him, and boo, he's chasing you. What you doing? You're a giggle.
Water wiggle!
Just wet in every wriggle. Water wiggle!
Water wiggle water toy. Your parents attach it to any garden hose. From Whammo.
There's a new cereal in the neighborhood with owls and ghosts.
Tastes real good.
Ghostbusters!
Marshmallow ghosts, fruit-flavored O's. Ghostbusters taste great with milk and juice and toast. A nutritious breakfast with a ghost.
Ghostbusters!
Fruit-flavored O's.
Ghostbusters!
Marshmallow ghosts.
Ghostbusters!
Say, what are you gonna crunch?
Now, back to our story. The neighbors all thought little Benicula was the cause of the white vegetables and the cause of the accidents that closed the plant. We got there seconds before the mob. Benicula was asleep in his shoebox, as if he'd never left.
What do we do?
Open up! It's Hank from down the street! Open the door!
We get Benicula out of here. That's what we do.
That rabbit of yours is a vampire. He's been turning all our vegetables white.
And he caused all those disasters at the food processing plant.
Yeah.
Hank, what would you do if someone woke you up at 1 a.m. to tell you there was a vampire rabbit in your house?
Well, I guess I'd think they went bananas.
Bingo.
Hey, there's the rabbit. The dog and cat have him.
After them!
Wait till we get our hands on that rabbit.
Either I'm having a terrible nightmare, or there's an angry mob out there stalking a vampire rabbit.
The area around our neighborhood is surrounded by dense thick forest, which is where we fled with Benicula. We figured that mob wouldn't follow us in here.
They went this way with the rabbit. Come on.
We were wrong.
They went this way, across the stream.
I sure wish I could sleep like that.
The least you could do is wake up. It's your life we're trying to save.
Our only hope is to head deeper into this pipe and see if there's another way out. Neither of us likes the idea of crawling through this dark, smelly pipeline.
Well, look who's awake. At last!
Don't fret, little fella. You're gonna be all right. I figured we'd all be all right. What I didn't figure on was where that drain pipe was gonna lead.
This must be the basement of the food processing plant.
And we aren't the only ones who've come through this pipe either. These footprints are wet and recent. I didn't tell Chester, but I had a hunch who had made those footprints we found. Okay, the coast is clear. No sign of them.
Them? Who's them? There's no them here. There's just us, isn't there?
I'm afraid not. And if I smell what I think I smell, I know what caused all the accidents that closed this plant.
What?
Them! They're cold wolves. Let's get out of here.
Sorry, Smiley, not this time. Uh-oh, I spoke too soon.
This is no time to get talkative.
Nice wolf, come up and chomp the kitty cat. The wolves are coming.
Quick, into that closet. Where's the rabbit?
I thought you had him.
Vernicula's out there.
With the wolves.
One little rabbit against three snarling, hungry wolves. Hardly seems fair. We were locked in the closet, and I still have no idea what went on outside that door.
Vampire.
Chester, listen. That's an alarm. Someone, I don't know who, had unlocked that door. When we looked out, all three wolves were trapped in a vat with a lid on it. And as for Vernicula, he was right where we left him.
What happened out here?
There's a perfectly logical explanation for this. And I wish I knew what it was. They took the wolves to a zoo and took us to the police station. It was morning before we finally got home.
The wolves will be well fed at the zoo. Apparently, they were sneaking into the plant at night in search of food.
Then the wolves chewed through the rope and caused the other accident.
Does that mean they're going to reopen the plant, Dad?
They sure are. Everyone goes back to work Monday morning. Our town is saved.
None of this explains the white tomatoes.
No, but I think I know what does. This bag has been sitting here for almost 2 weeks.
It's a head of lettuce, but it's all moldy and wilted.
Those are the vegetables we bought the night we found Vernicula.
That's right. And since that night, has either of you bothered to feed Vernicula?
I thought you were going to feed him. Why should I feed him? You found him.
You were both responsible. If you're going to have pets, you have to take care of them.
Poor Bunny was probably so hungry, he left his box in search of vegetable juices for nourishment.
But why just the juice?
Because he's just a baby.
Well, that explains the white tomatoes. They'll feed him regularly so he won't have to go roaming at night.
He looks so cute there. Imagine, I actually thought this was a vampire.
You and the neighbors all got carried away.
Vampire? Ridiculous!
Yeah, ridiculous!
We'll return after these messages.
Every time folks eat super fruity bonkers fruit candy, it makes a big hit. Know why bonkers is so super fruity? It's got a chewy fruity outside with an extra fruity inside. Makes me want to eat it up.
Bonkers bonks you out.
Some candy!
Anything like them before.
They say they're good luck.
My little pony, flutter pony.
With wings that flutter up and down.
Beautiful, magical,
fantastical.
My little pony, flutter pony.
There's no one else like you around.
Little Pony Flutter Ponies. Each sold separately. You can collect them all from Hasbro.
Captain O.G. Readmore here, an ordinary sidewalk on an ordinary day. But did you ever stop to think that you could get away, take a journey on a rocket, take a voyage on a ship? Just read a book and off you go, because reading is a trip. Explore a tropic jungle. Discover distant planets. Or reach the glacier's tip. Just read a book and off you go, because reading, yes, is a trip.
And now, here are the hosts of the ABC Weekend Special, Willie Tyler and Lester.
On the next Weekend Special, Quentin rescues a leprechaun.
Thanks for saving me life, lad.
Who grants his biggest wish.
I wish for all the money in the world.
And that's just what Quentin gets. Until he loses his best friends.
Come on, Quentin, you're making fun of us. Is this what you do when you have all the money in the world?
I don't know what's going on.
You wished for money, Quentin, not friends.
All the Money in the World, based on the novel by Bill Britton. Tomorrow, see the world's longest hot dog on Ripley's Believe It or Not. Monday, see daring stunts in the Circus World Championships and watch the world's strongest man try for a new record on That's Incredible. Tuesday, watch The Woman Who Willed a Miracle on the ABC After School Special. And now stay tuned for American Bandstand with Dick Clark, next on ABC.
Join Health Fair at Health Unlimited April 13th in Sacramento.
Hey, look at that. Nice to see you. In the video showcase today on American Bandstand, Mr. Robert Palmer will be here. In person, it will be Vanity. It will be Culture Club. You are in for a huge day. Come and join us on American Bandstand. Rolling now with In Excess. Thank you.
Well, I'm crazy for you, girl, cause we were terrible too. In our butterfly string to fit a 501 blue. Now our bodies grew up different, and I love your ways and me. Cause Levi's all we understood is out in the jeans. It's out in the jeans. A 501 jeans.
Are you ready? Because once you bite into a Three Musketeers bar, there's no turning back. It's so light it lifts you to the limited chocolate taste. With a center ripped like a chocolate cloud and coated in velvet smooth chocolate. Go on, lighten up with Three Musketeers and let your spirit soar.
In this portion of American Bandstand, our special in-person guest is Vanity. She'll be along in a moment. Here's Opus. All right, that's Opus. It's time now to rate a couple of records on American Bandstand. May I have your name and your age?
Cheryl, 18.
Thank you.
Chris, 17.
Thank you. As we go to rate these things, step off to your left a little bit and then think about a rating somewhere between 35 and 98. All right, here comes the first one. E.G. Daly and Say It, Say It.
Say it, say it, say it. What it's all about, say it.
shave an 85, Cheryl, an 80. It comes out an 82 and a half. Rate this one, if you will, 35 to 98. Take one step back, and here's Ish. You're My Only Lover. Form here a little bit, 80, 60, 85, 65, pardon me, ends up at 62 and a half. So the nod goes to E.G. Daly. Say it. Cheryl, you gave it an 80. Talk about it a little bit.
Well, it was easy to dance to. Everybody seemed to like it when it came on. Everybody got into it really quickly, you know.
Okay. Chris, you liked it even better. You gave it an 85.
It was a fun song. I enjoyed it. Everybody was getting into it.
Yeah. Will that ever be played on the radio a lot?
I think so.
Probably, yeah.
Be a hit.
Yeah.
Okay, 82 and a half is the rating. Let's see what we have for you. Cheryl, you'll receive from Jacques Moret the latest body wear for dance, exercise, and aerobics. Colorful and comfortable and fashionable from Jacques Moret. Moret Moves. Sherry. Yeah, she mispronounced your name already, Cheryl. You'll also receive from Cherokee American original apparel and shoes with a unique combination of fashion and comfort for women and girls from Cherokee. Chris, you'll receive the hair dryer and Jerry Redding milk and honey shampoo and conditioner. Leaves your hair the way nature meant it to be from Jerry Redding products. And Chris, you'll also receive an Art Carve class ring, choose from gold or palladium with the Art Carve full lifetime warranty. Art Carve at fine jewelry stores. And we'll be back with American Bandstand special guest, Vanity, after this.
Printed teas.
Richer chocolate taste made them better than ever, and now they're making them bigger than ever, too. New big bars of Baby Ruth and Butterfinger. Each one is a full quarter pound, almost twice the size of the regular singles bar. Chewy, nutty Baby Ruth and crispy, crunchy, peanut buttery Butterfinger are both better than ever. And the new big bar size means all that delicious taste lasts even longer. Check out these new Baby Ruth and Butterfinger big bars. They're tremendous.
It has two wheels and two sources of power. Goes from 0 to 192 in one shift and can take you places just standing still. The Yamaha DX100 synthesizer. Anything's possible.
Kellogg's Corn Pop Cereal. Golden nuggets of corn popped up sweet and light. A popping great part of this nutritious breakfast.
I gotta get pumped, yeah, I gotta get
pumped. About 10 seconds ago, this lady walked into the studio and everyone went, what is there about this woman that causes that reaction? Let me ask him.
Yeah. She's sexy.
Yes, she is. She's over there fraternizing with the troops now. Vanity. Back to your microphone. Silly fool.
Vanity kills.
The thing, she has something that is a mystique that a lot of people borrow, a lot of people copy. She's cute. Yeah. All right, you got it. She is a one of a kind. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Vanity. Hey, otherwise we'll never hear the ladies say a word. Are you ever aggravated by the fact that people copy what you do?
No, I think that's wonderful. I hope you copy this girl.
all the guys hope they'll copy that. What do those pants weigh? Are they heavy?
No, feel them. There you go.
Oh, I thought they were metal. They're not.
That's what they look like. They look like metal.
Are you and...
How you been?
I'm fine. I'm a little distracted by looking at you, but other than that, I'm fine. No, give it... I only got about 30 seconds. Let me ask three questions real fast. Are you an actor or a singer?
I'm an actress and a singer.
Do you want to be...
I got a new picture.
What is it?
With Roy Scheider and Anne Margaret, and it's called 52 Pickup. So I'm going to be a serious actress.
All right, fair enough. Will you travel where these people can see you in person rather than on film or television?
You know it.
When?
As soon as I finish the picture.
When's that going to be?
Oh, gosh. Probably, I'm going to go on a promotional tour for the album, actually. And probably the end of March or What's after March? April.
Yeah. These are the toughies. What's after March? Are you ready to go one more time?
Oh, absolutely.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, once again, here's Vanity.
And Doc Terror each sold separately.
Trouble uncovered, kid! Energize the assault mode!
Let's do it! My name is Doc Terror Dam! Centurion! Take this! Energize the power mode! Bombs away! Fire! Now, Doc Terror falls! Right, Jake?
Right, Ace!
New Centurions! Jake Rockwell, Ace McCloud, and Doc Terror come as shown, each sold separately.
Where's Schooler? Here, Sergeant! I have a letter here for you.
Thanks, sir.
The Army's special two-year enlistment can get you to college 2 years wiser.
and with the GI Bill and the Army College Fund, up to $17,000 richer.
We are holding a place for you in our next freshman class.
I'm in. I got it.
Guler.
Yes, Sergeant.
Just one more thing.
What's that, Sergeant?
Graduate.
There's a whole new way it moves today. Places to go, go, people to see. You gotta keep on moving this way. Chocolate caramel satisfaction. Like crispy cookie, get your back in the action.
You're in Zip Sneakers. You can pretend you're anything you want to be. Zips let you run as fast as your imagination. Get a free pair of sunglasses at participating Stride Rite stores while supplies last.
Next week, these folks will be here in person as our special guests, Sherelle and Alexander O'Neill.
You will be my
The Azizer polishing pen now has a new formula with a built-in base for richer shine, better coverage, longer wear. The better than ever Azizer polishing pen. You'll love it, or you'll get your money back.
Play, 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 baby!
Body sensing mist.
Light.
Hey!
Fun!
Ooh, everything he loves in you.
Play, 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 baby!
Baby, the fun way to sense yourself.
All over.
Hey, it's a great day, Vanity, in this half hour. Country Club in the next half hour. That's what they're all waiting for. They got their pictures over there. Oh, yes. And there's more good stuff happening right here on American Bandstand.
On the Disney Sunday Movie.
Dad.
A bizarre accident turns an average father into a superhero beyond his son's imagination. I-Man, Sunday.
The Grizzly, new at Great America. Crisp, roaring excitement.
Bring any Coke can to Great America and save $4 on each general admission.
You are invited to make this AB a weekly habit. Every Saturday, join us for the best in music, the best in dancing, the best in videos. Speaking of which, in the video showcase, we have one of the most talented men in all of music, Mr. Robert Palmer. That's Robert Palmer in the video showcase in the back there. I don't know whether you can see what's going on, but Vanity is still with us, signing autographs and what have you. In the meantime, in the spotlight dance, we've got Jermaine Jackson.
I'm here to make my feelings.
right, in the spotlight, Dan, let's find out who the participants were. May I have your name and your age, please?
17.
Thank you.
Renee, 19.
Thank you.
Stacy, 18.
Thank you.
Don, 19.
Thank you.
Tina,
18. Thank you.
Kevin, 20.
Thank you. Big day on American Bandstand. Vanity first, coming up, Culture Club.
Are you a zitzo? So paranoid about getting rid of zits, you'll believe anything. Try anything at all? Face the facts, zitzo. Benzoyl peroxide, the medication in Oxy-10, is recommended by doctors more than any other acne medicine you can buy. It's been proven effective in 14 clinical tests. Don't be a zitzo. Get Oxy-10 with the acne medication recommended most by doctors.
He's so cute,
too-lang.
And he drinks double fruit,
too-lang.
The new is high sea in town, their new is cool around,
cool.
And I'm really wild about
double
it,
cool, double fruit.
Tastes so wonderful to me,
double cool, double fruit.
Now I really want to shout it,
real fruit taste and vitamin C,
double cool, double fruit.
It's for him and for me,
double fruit, cool, double fruit from high sea.
There was no sound puppies before.
And now?
Yeah. And they're so lonely.
Let's rescue them.
Sound puppies eat sold separately.
They're so hungry.
They're very playful.
They catch sparks.
And for $3.50 more, you can send for a name tag, stickers, and owner certificate.
Now you're really one of the family.
Puppies, puppies, I want another puppy love.
Two new puppies from the Pound Puppies collection. Each sold separately. From Tonka.
Hi, Ernie. Hi, Ernie. Hey, you're a cookie.
A brand new Keebler cookie named E.L. Fudge. That's E as in everybody, L as in love, Fudge.
Pleased to meet you.
Rich, buttery shortbread cookies shaped like an elf, then dipped in smooth, creamy fudge. Everybody's gonna love E.L. Fudge.
I never met an elf with cookie I didn't like.
That's E as in everybody, L as in love's Fudge. New E.L. Fudge cookies from Keebler. You'll love them.
All right. Are you ready?
Yeah. Right.
Yes, bring him on.
Yeah.
Right. The interesting thing about this man and his friends is you never know what to expect. Such extraordinary exposure worldwide. Ladies and gentlemen, Culture Club.
Don't ask me, oh yeah.
Move, move,
again. Welcome back. If I may, George, you catch your breath, and I'll run about and speak with your friends. May I have your name, please?
I'm Roy.
Thank you, Roy, very much. Coming out from the rear. Yes.
Dick, baby, how are you?
Your name,
please. My name's John Moss. Thank you.
Thank you, John. Nice to welcome you. You know, George?
My name's Michael Craig.
Gentlemen, gather about, if you will. You've had extraordinary times in the spotlight. Does this cause you any problems?
No, we love it.
Is there any private life left?
Some. I'm not telling you about it, though.
I don't know if we want to hear about it right now. You're having a baby, or your wife is having a baby.
Yes.
Very well. Close. When does this transpire?
It's actually due on George's birthday, believe it or not.
Really?
Yeah.
Will you be touring at that time?
I hope not. No, I want to be there.
Are you going to tour at all this year?
No, I want to try and make work all his baby George, if I can.
No, did they not tell me, though, you were going to work in Europe?
We're going to tour Britain and possibly America, but that's about it this year.
Sorry, we're touring the States in August and September.
August and September. Let me ask one question I don't know whether any of you can answer, but after this extraordinary, fierce spotlight of attention after all this time, is there any way to top yourselves?
Yeah, I think you always can sort of go one further. Definitely. You just get more attention.
Enjoy it?
Yeah, it's good.
Tell the truth. Do you enjoy all of this?
Yeah, I do.
You wouldn't do anything else.
So, I mean, you're really lucky to have a job that you enjoy, so we're lucky. Because it's a job that we enjoy and we enjoy doing it. And it's very hard in life to have a job that you actually like.
John, when will we see you again in person?
In person?
In the flesh, in concert.
August. Hold it. You don't give me the mic there.
He's learned. You don't have the mic, you don't talk.
Yes. Give me the mic. August the 20th, guys. I don't know where it's going to be, but it'll be in a town near you. Thank you. You're over there. Great.
What is this, a commercial already? Good luck with the baby. Thank you so very much. Ladies and gentlemen, Culture Club. Here's Stevie Nicks.